Welcome, dear students, to yet another short lecture on the history of English language and literature. We shall have a short discussion today about the British Empire during the Victorian era. By the end of the 19th century, the British Empire had become the mighty empire, of the world, with colonies in many parts of the world. So, the mighty British Empire of the Victorian era. So, naturally, you will ask a question, what is the meaning of an empire? What is an empire? An empire would mean a group of states or countries ruled over by a single monarch or a single authority. So, a group of states or countries ruled over by a single monarch or a single authority. So, the British Empire is the group of countries ruled over by England, by the monarch of England. The British Empire consisted of colonies or territories ruled or administered by United Kingdom. So, that is the meaning of an empire. That is the meaning of the great British Empire. When Queen Victoria came to the throne in 1837, the British already governed Canada, large areas of India, Australia and New Zealand, and small parts of South America and Africa. So, together all these countries formed the great British Empire. Now, you will ask, how did this great British Empire emerge? How did this great British Empire come about? The great British Empire originated with the overseas colonies and trade posts. Britain was the birthplace of industrial revolution. We have learned that. And we see the advancement of science and technology in England. Due to the industrialization and the expansion of science and technology, we see a commercial expansion of Britain taking place. And this commercial expansion would empower Britain to spread his empire far and wide. Now, at the peak of his power, the phrase, "the empire on which the sun never sets," was often used to describe the British Empire, because its expanse around the globe meant that the sun was always shining on at least one of its territories. So, the empire on which the sun never sets. The British Empire was known as the empire on which the sun never sets. How did India become the colony of Britain? Now, that question, how India became the colony of Britain, is quite relevant to us. We are Indians. We have heard about the East India Company. We know that it was an English, East India Company was an English company that was formed to trade in the Indian Ocean region. The company received the Royal Charter to trade in the Indian Ocean region. Now, what is a Royal Charter? A Royal Charter is a formal grant issued by a monarch under the royal prerogative as letters. So, it is an order issued by the monarch to trade in the Indian Ocean region. The company received the Royal Charter from Queen Elizabeth I in 1600 to trade with the Indies. So, the East India Company would come to India for the sake of trade. So, they are coming for the sake of trade in the beginning, and they would trade with the Mughals of India. So, in the beginning, they would trade with the Mughals of India. They came for trade, and gradually they would seize control of the large part of the Indian subcontinent. Initially, their interest was only to trade with India, but gradually, their interest was changed to building an empire. So, those who came for trade, the company that came for trade, would take control of the entire region. We can say that their interest shifted from trade to territory. Slowly, Britain will make her presence felt very strongly in India with the East India Company as the controlling body. Now you will ask, when did Britain take the direct control of India? They were ruling through the East India Company till now. Now when did they take the direct control? Now we have heard about the First War of Independence of 1857. The First War of Independence of 1857 in India. It is also called the Indian Rebellion of 1857. It was a major uprising in India against the rule of the British East India Company. Now, at the time of the rebellion, most of India was under the control of British East India Company. Now, after the rebellion of 1857, the British will take the direct control of India. So, when did British take direct control of India? After the First War of Independence in 1857. Now, what was the immediate cause for this rebellion, the First War of Independence? The immediate cause was this. The company had made cartridges greased with the fat of cows and pigs. These cartridges had to be bitten off before using. We know that these cartridges are used in guns. They had greased the cartridges with the fat of cows and pigs. And you know, most of the army consisted of Muslims and Hindus. The cow was the holy animal of the Hindus and the pig was haram for Muslims. And majority of the army were Hindus and Muslims. And the cartridges used in the guns were greased with the fat of cows and pigs. Now, this would anger the army. This was the immediate reason. So, the using or greasing of the cartridges with the fat and cows, fat of cows and pigs were the, was the immediate reason for the rebellion. Now, apart from this reason, the Indians were angry with the British for several other reasons. The first reason was that there was a forced conversion by missionaries. The missionary priests used to convert Indians to Christianity forcefully. Second was the doctrine of lapse by Lord Dalhousie. According to this doctrine of lapse, kingdoms of childless kings. India was a union of many kingdoms, we know. India was not a single country as it is now. There were many kingdoms and many kings. The kingdoms with the childless kings would fall or would lapse to British. The British will take control of those kingdoms in which the king did not have a child. There was a total destruction of the cottage industries by flooding of British finished products. This was another reason for the mutiny, the rebellion. And the rebellion broke out in Meerut and slowly spread to several parts of the country. The rebellion started by the sepoys. Sepoys means the soldiers. It is also known as the sepoy mutiny. The rebellion began with the soldiers. Soon the princes, the nobles and other people who resented the British rule in India would join, and the leaders of the sepoy mutiny or the First War of Independence or the rebellion of 1857 were Mangal Pandey, Rani Lakshmi Bai of Jhansi, Tandia Top, etc. And as history states, the rebellion ended in a failure. The main reason for the failure of the rebellion was the lack of leadership and the lack of arms and ammunitions. Though the rebellion was a failure, it made clear that the East India Company could no longer control the administration of such a large country like India. So it was a warning to the Britishers, to the East India Company, that the Indians are going to revolt against their rule in India. The First War of Independence in India in 1857 was suppressed and the British government took over the rule of India from the East India Company. So, the East India Company would give in the control to the British government after the rebellion of 1857. My dear students, the British had begun to rule India through the East India Company from 1757 onwards with the Battle of Plassey. And the British will take over the rule from the East India Company from 1857. And as we know, they will rule India till 1947. Thus, India was the colony of Britain for almost 200 years. They would plunder the great resources of India. My dear students, when we discuss India and the British Empire, one thing that we should remember is this, that in 1876, by an act of parliament, conferred on Queen Victoria the title Empress of India. Queen Victoria became the Empress of India in 1876. So my dear students, with this we are coming to the close of this lecture, this short lecture on the British Empire and India. In this short lecture we have discussed about the British Empire, the mighty British Empire, the empire on which the sun never sets. And we also discussed how India became a colony of the British Empire. The Britain ruled India through the East India Company, and we said East India Company came to India for the sake of trade. The company that came to India for the sake of trade would slowly establish its control in India, and they will take over the whole territory of India and will begin to rule India. The British government will take control, direct control of India from 1857, after the first battle of independence. The first battle of independence, or the first rebellion, or the Sepoy mutiny that happened in 1857. The mutiny was suppressed, the first war of independence was suppressed, but Britishers will take the direct control of India from 1857. And we also said that in 1876, Queen Victoria will become the Empress of India. For your assignment today, dear students, please write a short summary of the British Empire and India, and how India came under the direct rule of Britishers after the First War of Independence. Thank you for your patient listening. Hope to see you with another lecture soon. Have a nice day.